Hello, in an earlier video, I demonstrated how to use the IR sensor and remote to control the EV3 by activating the app on the EV3 brick. In this video, I will show a program to do the same, but this can be activated remotely. I use it when a program I am working on doesn't work out like it should. I can upload this to the robot and drive it back to me without having to get up. This works best if you have a Netgear N150 wireless USB. The first thing I added was an infinite loop. Inside the loop, I added some variables to control the motor speed. This is helpful, as you will see, as it makes it easy to change the speed throughout the program by changing the values in just these two blocks. I have a motor forward variable and a motor backward variable. My EV3 is set up like tracker, so the motor direction is reversed. Next, I have a switch block set to infrared sensor, measure, remote. The infrared sensor is connected to port 4 on the brick. The remote is set to channel 1. When using these switch settings, it allows you to add additional arguments to the switch by clicking the plus button. I set the first argument to no buttons pushed on the remote. By clicking the radio button, this sets this as the default state. I've placed a move tank block set to off and brake, which will stop the robot if all buttons are released. I've also included a brick status light set to on, red, and pulse. The program will return back to the infinite loop and stay there until a button on the remote is pushed. The rest of the arguments are based on which buttons are pushed on the remote. If the top two buttons are pushed, there is a move tank block set to on with the motor forward variable managing the speed of each motor to make the tracker move forward in a straight line. There is a brick status light block set to green. The next argument has the top left button and the bottom right button pressed. Once again, there is a move tank block and a brick status light block set to green. This time there is a move forward variable connected to the left motor and a move backward variable connected to the right, which causes the tracker to rotate to the right. The next argument is the opposite, with the bottom left and the top right button pushed. Reverse the motors and the tracker rotates to the left. When the two bottom buttons are pushed, there is a motor backwards variable feeding the motor speed of the move tank block, which causes the tracker to move backwards in a straight line. The last four arguments are if each of the four buttons are pressed by themselves. Top left button sees the left side of the move tank block fed by a move forward variable, which will turn the tracker to the right. Top right is the opposite and will turn the tracker to the left. Bottom left button will turn the tracker backwards to the right, and bottom right will turn the tracker backwards to the left. I hope you find this video helpful. As I mentioned earlier, I keep this program open while I'm working on other programs. That way I can easily upload it to the tracker if the program I am working on doesn't go as planned. That way I can control the robot to bring it back to me without having to get up. Yeah, I'm that lazy. Check out my other videos on my website, www.av1.com/ev3. Thank you.